our meeting. They just beginning at this moment.
Professor, tá ao vivo. Você quer fazer uma breve introdução já?
Hoje, nós vamos ter a apresentação de algumas pesquisas que foram conduzidas pelos estudantes, né? Nossos estudantes, juntamente conosco. Today we will present some research that our students conducted related to COVID and its impacts on business and consumer behavior. Next meeting, we will continue this presentation discussing the research. So, to begin, I will ask to Matheus Berto, to talk about his research and share with us the results of its research. So, it's a pleasure to receive you, Matheus. Now you can present.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone, or good evening. I think in France it's 7 p.m. Let me share my presentation. Okay, you can all see?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Yes, it is good.
Okay, fantastic. So this study was conducted by me, Professor Edgar, and Professor Janaína, and we studied the relationship between consumption and fear of COVID in Brazil. The purpose of our study is to analyze the fear and the consumption during the pandemic here in Brazil, and we study a few aspects of consumption that we are going to see ahead. So the first hypothesis is that the Brazilians have stocked food and daily use products because the literature about COVID around the world show that people has this consumption habits during the COVID pandemic, and we try to see if it's true here in Brazil either. The second hypothesis is that we believe that Brazilians had shopped more online than they used to do in the pre-pandemic period, because other studies show that's a behavior of the consumers on the pandemic of COVID. And the third hypothesis is that we believe that Brazilians have more purchase in smaller business near home, or smaller business to see less people, because other studies show that's another behavior, another buying behavior. The instrument of our study was a questionnaire with 12 sentences that studies the fear and the consumption. There was nine questions about Brazilians' fear of COVID, and another three questions about the consumptions, the fear and the consumptions among the Brazilians. I will not stick to that questions, because they will be better showed ahead, okay? The method was a self-administered questionnaire sent between August 10th and 31st. We interviewed 246 consumers, and the interpretations were made using descriptive statistics and factor analysis. The sample characterization was made using age and gender as factor, and we emphasis the age of 21 to 40 years, and the female, we see that's the biggest, the largest amount of person. The descriptive statistics attitudes toward COVID-19 showed that people is afraid of COVID. They were uncomfortable about think of COVID. They are avoiding crowding because of COVID, and they have adhered to social isolation because of COVID. So here at Brazil, the people are very concerning about COVID, and they are trying their best to stay away from the disease. Okay. The descriptive statistic of attitudes toward consumption and the COVID pandemic shows that people are buying more over internet than they used to do on the pre-pandemic period, and they are shopping in smaller stores to avoid crowding spaces, but they are not stocking food. We thought that was going to be a point, but they are not stocking food here in Brazil. And ahead, we're going to see why we think that. Okay. Another result. It's that the Brazilian has some psychological damage because of COVID. So they are opinions more favorable when we talk about sentiments. So if they are afraid, if they think about, if they think they're going to die, if they're nervous, but they don't have physical damage about COVID. So when we ask if her hands are sweating, or he's a trouble sleeping, or he didn't eat or something about COVID, that doesn't happen. When we thought about social habits, we too have favorable opinions. So people are having changing their social lives. They are avoiding crowding places. They are adhering to isolation, but the consumption attitudes are a little bit divided. Some people think the consumption attitudes changed. Some people doesn't think. Okay, so the results. Okay, I already thought the results. This place. The other results that we put emphasis because was the most interesting fact or data that we saw on the factorial analysis. And the on this analysis, we saw that there is a lot of changing or a lot of positive data when we talk about the fear of COVID, but there isn't such positive data when we think about the fear of COVID and consumption. We saw that the avoidance of agglomeration and the social isolation and the fear of pandemic increases online shopping. And that's the most significant data that we saw when we cross the consumption and the fear. The other ones was not that expressive. There was a lot of weak correlations or moderate correlations, and the most of these correlations was on the fear of COVID, but not on the COVID and the fear and consumptions. And possible interpretations. 55% of our interviewers was less than 40 years old. And those was the population that wasn't so impacted of the pandemic. Numbers of death or serious health conditions. And so maybe that's one of the reasons for those people has changed less their consumptions, their consumptions habits, because they continues to work, they wasn't in home office, they went to gyms, they went to supermarkets. So that's one reason. The other reason is the Brazilian political and economic environment that unfortunately isn't so good. And that environment makes that people has less condition of buying on big volumes or go to markets on the neighborhoods that by tradition here in Brazil cost has higher prices. So that's another reason why the habit of consumption here in Brazil is different from another studies. And the most important difference between our studies and the studies that were used on our on the basis of our articles was that those studies were made on the beginning of the pandemic. Is studies from June, July, August 2020, when there was was difficult to see the pandemic future. We didn't have vaccines, we didn't have a bigger knowledge about the pandemic behavior. So those people, or including us, on that moment were more concerned about the pandemic. This study was made 15 months after the beginning on a scenario with vaccines, with much a population already fully immunized, when people are beginning to live their life. So the scenario is a bit changed. So the answers was expected that was changed too, okay? So our first hypothesis about the Brazilian stocking food and daily products were rejected. Our second hypothesis hypothesis, I'm sorry, of the Brazilians having some chopped through online stories. It was confirmed. Or hypothesis that Brazilians had made purchase in smaller stories were confirmed, but not with such a big number of respondents that we thought we were going to have. And it's important to be clear that they're just preliminary results. We are going to make further investigation. The article are not fully wrote. So maybe some of those data are going to change, but the basis of our studies is this. I'm not fine if I were, if I made me understood, my English is a little rust, but if we have some questions, you can make, and thank you. Let me see the chat.
Thank you, Matheus. You made a good presentation. It's a preliminary presentation. We will develop more, but the ideas presented are very interesting. These ideas, we can see that the fear was not so strong to people to stock food, there is many interesting aspects to analyze in this data collected by Matheus, and we'll conduct some another meetings to discuss possible investigations, additional investigations that could generate more evaluations about this data. So it is very good. I think that using correlations and using descriptive analytics, you present some interesting aspects related to COVID in Brazil. And it's very interesting because in the literature, people said that there is a trend to stock, and this not occur probably because people, we conduct the research sometime after the beginning of the pandemics. If someone have some question to Matheus, it's a good moment. I want to remember all that we stay in a exploratory stage, not conclusive yet. But it's interesting if someone wants to discuss another points to Matheus before we begin another presentation. So, if someone wants to talk something, is the time now. Tumba?
Yes, I would have several questions because it's very interesting preliminary results, and I think there is a very promising other results to come with a multivariate statistics to do. Just a question about the questionnaire. Were there many people that do not respond to the questionnaire?
We sent those, there was a link that we send by WhatsApp and by Facebook groups. So I don't know the number of people that received those link and did not respond. I don't know, but by the numbers of people that were on the WhatsApp groups and that were on the Facebook groups, I think that more people did not respond that respond, but I don't know the exactly number.
This we will need to correct if we will submit to another journal. Probably we will conduct one convening sample more than yes. aleatory sample.
Okay, yeah, it makes more sense.
It's a yes, convenience sample. But it is exploratory and you have a good number of your answers.
Is it possible to see again the correlation matrix?
Yeah.
Because it was quite interesting. There were a lot of
that meme.
Quite high correlation coefficients. And just by seeing the correlation matrix, we maybe could think about what happens if we perform a factor analysis like a principal component analysis. Yes. So of course, there is a size effect, everything is positive. And maybe we expect to find, I don't know, but with your sentences, there are two kinds of sentences. If I'm agree, the first kind is about the fear of the pandemic, and the second kind is about the behavior when purchasing some things. Maybe do you expect to find these two kinds of sentences into factors when you will perform a factor analysis? That is a first factor with most of the first items, maybe the second, the fourth, the fifth, sixth, and seventh, and maybe another one with the 11th and the 12th. Maybe the ninth will be also the eighth. Sorry, will be also in the subfactor. So, what do you think? Or have you already conducted such an analysis?
We made one factor analysis and was generated five factors, general factor analysis. And it was very interesting. And Matheus can present this data, but probably we will discuss this more deeply.
The next time.
Next time, yes.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah,
the results are very interesting with 0.82. It's a good number to a exploratory number, but we have to analyze. It was very interesting. I was just discussing with Janaína, the orienter of Professor Matheus, because in the factor analysis, we can see the factor fear on one side, and the other side, and there were formed clusters relating some kind of behavior, and Matheus don't present because we are just discussing the data just yet. But it's very interesting to analyze more deeply after. In this moment, we imagine that the correlation with the descriptive analysis could made some good ideas of possible investigations.
Yeah.
Do you want to explain more, Matheus?
The data bank was collected about 15 years ago. We finished on August 31st. So there is a lot of studies there is other kinds of studies that we want to make with the data bank. And we don't know if it's just one article with everything or another spin-off with the data bank on another another point of view. That's the preliminary results, but there's other things coming. We don't know if it's just one article with everything or two or more articles with the data. It was a very rich data.
Yes, because you can do a lot of statistical analysis. And for example, another example that you could do is that maybe could help you to validate your hypothesis. If I'm right, you have an hypothesis such like a Brazilian shopped more online. And if you want to see if it is related to the fear of the pandemic, maybe you could split your data set into two parts. On one side, people who are not afraid about the pandemic. On the other side, people who are afraid of the pandemic. So you can use your principal component, your factor analysis to do the split. And you just then have to compare the means of the score on the sentence number 11 about, no, it's not the 11. Yes, it's the 11 about purchasing online, for instance, and to see if there is a significant difference between the two means. It's just an idea, maybe not relevant when you perform the calculus, but just an idea.
Very good idea. That's something for think about. I'm going to write those ideas. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. So I don't have another question, so I can let the speech to someone else. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
So, thank you for your comments, Romain. Now, it's a preliminary presentation. Probably we will need to conduct one meeting to discuss this. And I have the results of the factorial analysis and the results, even the tests was very good. Surprisingly, because the numbers not so, the survey is not so big, but there was a very interesting adherence to the discussion. I was just talking with Janaína about this. But this probably we will send to one academic journal with a more structured discussion. I want to see if there is more doubts. No doubts? Matheus, thank you for your presentation.
Thank you.
Matheus was doing his PhD here at the school with Professor Janaína, and work hard to conduct this in a small time. Congratulations, Matheus, for this job. Yes, thank you. And thank you for your job and your involvement with this research.
Thank you.
Now, I will ask you, if Letícia could present to us. Letícia was doing her Master of Science at UNESP, and I teach at UNESP too, and I propose to my students to conduct research investigating COVID and impacts on consumption of food. And Letícia made this research analyzing the consumption of fresh food during the pandemics. Letícia?
Oi, professor.
If you can speak in Portuguese, I will translate after each chart. Or if you want to talk in English, there's no problem. What do you prefer? O que você prefere, Letícia? Fazer em português e eu traduzo? Ou
pode ser, professor.
Apresentar em inglês? Então tá bom. Então fala em português e eu traduzo. Letícia will speak in Portuguese and then I will translate.
Primeiramente, boa tarde a todos. O trabalho foi realizado pelos meus orientadores, professora Edgar, professora Sheila e eu, Letícia Maurício. Como o professor já disse, sou aluna da Unesp e a investigação foi sobre a mudança nos hábitos alimentares durante a pandemia do Covid. E o foco foi nos alimentos frescos e mais saudáveis.
Afternoon for all. Letícia was doing Master of Science in Business at UNESP and conducted her research with Professor Sheila and me. I teach together with Professor Sheila at UNESP too. Pode mudar.
Bom, a COVID-19, como nós já vimos, causou muita incerteza e muitas dificuldades em toda a população mundial.
A COVID caused uncertainties and difficulties in all the population.
E algumas necessidades foi fazer o bloqueio total de todas as atividades para não ter tanto contágio da COVID-19. Então, a população teve que ficar em casa nesse período.
The COVID causes a lot of changes in the population, causing block of the activities, impacting different fields. And this was not different in Brazil.
E os impactos foram em todas as áreas, tanto na econômica, nas políticas públicas e nas pessoas também. Então, desemprego, a fome, e as pessoas em casa têm mais chance de doenças. Houve aumento também de feminicídio. Cada país teve a sua realidade, né? Então, o impacto foi geral e realmente, assim, é difícil porque afetou a rotina de todos. Então, todos os chefes de Estado tiveram que tomar atitudes drásticas para tentar não aumentar esse contágio.
In her research, Letícia saw that in all the world there are a lot of changes in the routine with some strong changes in the everyday life. Even in Brazil, we have some problems that emerged and some increased, like feminicide, like the death of women that increase this period.
Então, uma medida, né, como já foi falado, foi o bloqueio total e as severas restrições. E nessas severas restrições, com o pessoal mais em casa, O que aconteceu? O pessoal precisava se alimentar, que é a principal fonte de sobrevivência humana. E é isso que o estudo tem por objetivo. Observar como que a pandemia influenciou o consumo de alimentos mais frescos e saudáveis, né, durante esse período.
Yes, the main goal, main objective of Letícia was to investigate the pandemic influences on consumer behavior of food, mainly fresh and healthy foods, if this have an increase during the pandemics.
A metodologia foi executada em maio, a coleta de dados, e foi usada a metodologia exploratória descritiva Perdão, professor.
Pode falar. Fala em português, por quê?
Tá. Foram realizados em 15 estabelecimentos entrevistas com o questionário estruturado, e 5 dessas entrevistas foi analisado com base na análise de conteúdo para fazer uma vertente, um entendimento do proprietário, dos gerentes desses estabelecimentos, para saber da opinião deles como que estava sendo a venda, se houve aumento ou não por parte desses estabelecimentos.
Yes. Letícia conducted one research. It was a sample of 15 companies that sells fresh food and food to evaluate if there are changes during this period. And additionally, she conducted 5 in-depth interviews with some managers of some selected establishments.
Bom, os resultados. Houve um significativo aumento nas vendas desses alimentos mais frescos e saudáveis. E é um fato, porque as pessoas estando em casa, elas precisam cozinhar mais, a família acabou ficando mais em casa, não separada. Então, a opção maior é fazer essa comida em casa. Então, esse pode ser um fato que tenha aumentado essas vendas.
So, Letícia found that people in this period increase the consumption of fresh and healthy foods. Probably because people stay more at home for this consumption during this period.
E os resultados também revelaram que a considerável, né, aumento da demanda, né, por esses alimentos tem a ver também tanto com ao lockdown, né, mas aqui, pelo menos no Brasil, a gente teve o aumento muito grande da carne. Então, as pessoas começaram a optar ter que inserir na alimentação esses outros alimentos, pelo também preço da carne.
There was another factor to be evaluated. During this period, meat have a great increase in prices in Brazil. This stimulates that people change their consumption patterns, changing the consumption of meat to other kinds of food.
E a Organização Mundial da Saúde, como em 2021 até, fez alguns pedidos para a população se alimentar melhor. Então, a base de uma boa saúde é uma alimentação baseada em alimentos minimamente processados, que são os mais saudáveis e frescos. Então, é uma recomendação que nós temos, e esse aumento que teve deve ser justamente pela preocupação das pessoas com a saúde. Quando a população que no início teve mais morte e tal na pandemia, foram as que tinham comorbidades, problemas de saúde. Então, essa preocupação com a saúde pode ter sido um fator nesse aumento de vendas.
It was an exploratory research, but Leticia thinks that probably this option for healthy foods may be connected to the recommendations that WHO made to people to change their habits, food habits, consuming more healthy foods.
E aqui na cidade onde foi feito o estudo, houve um aumento em todas as classes que foram estudadas, como as frutas, os vegetais, raízes e tubérculos.
In the city that was conducted the investigation, occurred an increase in the all the categories of healthy foods, like roots, vegetables and tuber. All these categories increased the pandemics. And this data was obtained with the interview with the managers of establishments that sells food.
E a população estando em casa, né, durante o bloqueio, houve sim esse aumento. E em um dos relatos, em uma rede de supermercado, a pandemia causou um efeito nas pessoas que foi a compra por pânico. Então, as pessoas, por medo, compravam em estoque, queriam estocar a comida. Então, essa também é uma possibilidade. Houve um aumento, né, porque as pessoas estavam mais preocupadas. E teve um caso em um mercado que eles até precisaram mudar o layout do setor de hortifruti de tanto que as vendas aumentaram. Porém, não foi só no início da pandemia ou por pânico, mas porque as pessoas estavam mesmo preocupadas com a questão da saúde. Então, a venda foi, no começo, muito, muito alta, mas ela manteve alta.
Yes, Leticia also talked that there is a strong worry with healthy foods. Even one supermarket have to change the area that to sell vegetables and roots to increase this department because the loss are great search for this kind of food.
Concluindo, então, a pandemia, né, promoveu diversos hábitos nas pessoas, e com esse estudo tivemos um aumento significativo no aumento de compras de produtos no setor de hortifruti.
Yes, and this, the main conclusion this study was that in this investigation there were around increase in the consumption of fresh food during the pandemics in Brazil. Taking this seat and this investigation as a proxy to talk about this.
Os resultados em todas as categorias tiveram aumento. Foi a alimentação, o interesse pela alimentação de alimentos, por alimentos mais frescos e saudáveis, teve um aumento. E o que supõe-se é que esses hábitos vão se manter. Então, fica aberto aí para novos estudos, para ver se realmente vai manter, se a população está mais preocupada mesmo. Mas nesse estudo foi provado que na cidade, na cidade estudada, houve sim um aumento da compra desses alimentos mais frescos e saudáveis.
Yes, this investigation, we conclude that in this city, the research was conducted, there was a significant increase in the consumption of fresh and healthy foods during the pandemics. We needed to make the additional investigations to evaluate if this will pay or if this change will occur in the next months, causing changing habits in consuming habits for a fresher and healthier food. Letícia, obrigado. Thank you, Letícia. Some doubts?
Obrigada, professor. Obrigada a você. Eu não estou conseguindo tirar.
Eu também vi esse problema. Só eu acho que o Fernando está nos ouvindo. Como que ela atirou?
Consegui. Obrigada. Obrigada a todos.
Thank you, Letícia. Letícia was talking that it's the first time that she presents an academic study. So it's a beginning. Você está começando, Letícia, assim mesmo. Roman, there is someone with doubts?
Just if I can just ask a little question, because I'm not sure to what happened in Brazil about your lockdown and the recommendation of your authorities. I was wondering if your authorities recommended to the population to eat healthy during the pandemic more than any other period. For instance, in France, well, we are used every time to see some messages about eating healthy. But these messages were not so numerous during the pandemic. The messages of the government, the recommendation, were to wash the hands, to put a face mask, to limit social distance, et cetera, et cetera. So in France, we do not have special messages about eating healthy during the pandemic. So I was wondering if in Brazil, there were such messages.
No. Roman está perguntando se no Brasil teve mensagens específicas para a população consumir comida mais saudável nesse período. Eu falei para ele que, preliminarmente, não. Você quer falar alguma coisa, Letícia?
Professor, é isso. Não teve, né? Foi isso, mais isso. A própria população mesmo que se conscientizou.
Yes, Letícia talked, and I saw this too, that there wasn't a specific message in Brazil to talk to people eat more healthy food. And this occurred naturally. People naturally change some consumption food habits to have a consumption of more healthier and fresher food. This occurred naturally, probably because day to day, we consume the, we have a consumption of very processed food, and with the pandemics, this kind of opportunity to consume it, to the consumption of processed food, changed it so much. Eu falei para ele que provavelmente porque mudou inclusive as possibilidades de consumir comida processada durante a pandemia, né, Letícia?
Isso.
If I may.
Yes.
My wife is a doctor, and she says that a lot of her patients changed their habits during the pandemics. The people that were in home office and had more time, they began to eat better and make exercise and read more and see films and TV series that they usually doesn't have time to do because they work and they didn't stay home and their life were very fast. And this quarantine made those people make better habits, see food networks and want to make those recipes at home. And maybe that's one of the reasons for that change of consumption on supermarkets for healthy foods or something.
Yes, people have to spend time during the lockdown, especially if they could not work remotely. So they do not have to work, they have nothing to do, so they have to spend time. So they may cook, it's a way to spend time. We saw that also in France. People, especially during the first lockdown, people have to spend time, so they cooked at home. And also in France, there were a TV show made during the lockdown, a chef in his kitchen was cooking something live, and people could also do the same recipe at home because you can go to the social network or to the internet to see what the recipe, so what you have to buy, and you can do the recipe live, and it was a great success. This TV show was a great success. It was an unexpected success because it was made with nothing, just the chef, the cook, and the camera. So that's all. So it was a great success. So people wanted to spend time with cooking.
Here in Brazil, it happens too, but not TV program. It's smaller programs on the internet. They send the ingredients of the recipes, and the recipes is going to be made 3-4 days, and you buy everything and you can cook with the chef. It happens. It's already happened. Yeah.
Tanto o Roman comentou que na realidade, na França tem um programa que faz muito sucesso, que inclusive discute essa questão da comida mais saudável. E o Matheus também colocou que a esposa dele é médica e que observou também que as pessoas estão se alimentando melhor. Durante a pandemia, estão tendo mais tempo para cozinhar melhor. It's very interesting, these observations, because confirmed the observation that Leticia conducted in her investigation that people during pandemics changed their food habits. And maybe because they have more time to cook, more time in house with the social distancing.
Professor Edgar, can I add to something?
Yes. Depois eu ia te pedir, faça a tradução para o português, que é bom, porque a gente não sabe quantas pessoas estão assistindo a gente, e é interessante, porque a gente fazer a ponte, que às vezes tem alunos que podem ter dificuldade para português. Por favor, então, Cris.
Posso colocar em português e como você prefere?
Não, faz como você preferir.
Tá bom.
Prefere.
Posso fazer um pouquinho nos dois aí?
Yes, yes.
Resolve para os dois públicos, né? Não, o que eu acho interessante é como a gente, né, no grupo tem essas duas, a gente está olhando produtos de consumo, mas a gente também está olhando a questão da cultura, né, como também essa, como mercadoria, também como bem de consumo, e a gente vai ver mais sobre isso no próximo encontro. É bem interessante também, fazendo o link com o que a Letícia trouxe e o Matheus também, se a gente pensar em no que é saudável mentalmente, né, na saúde mental. Então, a arte, e o Matheus comentou isso também da leitura, também houve esse aumento, né, no consumo, ou seja, na recepção, né, na visita a museus virtuais, a exposições virtuais, que talvez não esteja diretamente ligada à troca, né, à compra e venda, mas fez parte aí para trabalhar a questão da saúde mental, o consumo da arte e de cultura. So what I just want to add that in the we are also studying the cultural and artistic consumption, and in this sense we also could view that we're going to explain and we're going to touch it more in the next workshop, that in terms of mental health, we could see this increasement of the consumption of art and cultural aspects, because people, when they were isolated in their house, they also they bought more art. When you think about paintings, for example, but also they consume more. They visit more museums. They also participate in virtual rooms to visiting exhibitions. So we could see also this consumption increasement in terms of buying art, or also just recepting and searching for cultural and reading consumption. That's it.
Yes, thank you, Chris, for your comments. Very interesting comments that the artistic perception, there are some similar changes. The next October 8th, I want to see some of the more in deep analysis of the cultural market, what's happening. Because I'm curious to see what's happening in the artistic scenario too. So I want to share one presentation that one student of me conducted. I have one student here. It's in Brazil. It's common that one student need to conduct one bachelor job to receive, we call it the concluding course job, and this originated one proposition of the article that was accepted, and I want to share with you this. I will try how to share this, and probably here. Can you see here?
Yes.
Ah, thank you. So we will discuss one study that one student conducted. It is very interesting study, because this student that concluded his bachelor course in business, made one evaluation of the implementation. Of one e-commerce in a medium-sized textile industry. This generated one article accepted that will be presented in one conference. So we will see an introduction, objective, as Bob Gregorio reveal, material methods, results, and final considerations. And the textile sector is very important. It's one of the oldest commercial segments of humanity. In underdeveloped countries is very important. Have high competitiveness and access of supply from countries with cheap labor. India, China, and Pakistan have a lot of cheap labor related to the textile industry. We can imagine that Brazil, the textile industry in Brazil is the fifth largest in the world. It corresponds to 1.5 million direct jobs and 8 million indirect jobs. So 75% of the workforce is female. Is the second largest employer in Brazil. What happened? What we will discuss? We will discuss the textile adaptation of sales channels. And this is very interesting because the number of online consumers grew on average 34% each year between 2013 to 2018. And COVID pandemics accelerated the development of this market. The general objective was to analyze for financial, organizational, and customer relationship criteria the impacts of implementing direct sales, B2C, from e-commerce. The Star Cluster in São Paulo state, according to Porter, cluster is a geographically concentrated grouping of interrelated companies from a certain sector and related institutions, linked by common and complementary elements. The conglomerate of the city of Ibitinga, the study was conducted in Ibitinga, is located 380 kilometers from the capital and has a population of 6,000 inhabitants. There is one recognition, National Embroidered Capital Nacional do Bordado. Marketplace is a virtual mall. The students discuss the marketplace como shopping virtual. Advantages: great brand awareness, reduced costs, expanded consumer market access, control of the final sale price. Muitas algumas vantagens, maior conhecimento, custos reduzidos, um acesso expandido, maior e controle do preço final. Some disadvantages: difficulty maintaining customers, working B2B, and changing the production structure follows the new sales dynamic. Existe uma desvantagem, em B2B, você tem um contato, e isso daí muda quando você muda para esse novo ambiente. The new environment is more dynamic. Provides changes in corporate structures and process improvements. The marketplace gera mudanças na estrutura corporativa e nos processos. Também a gente teve uma expansão das receitas usando tecnologia, expansion of revenue using technology. E-commerce, né, can be understood as the station of traditional commerce. O e-commerce pode ser compreendido como uma extensão do comércio tradicional. So, here we can see some disruptions that occurred during pandemics. We have a demand shock and one demand supply shock. One shock of supply and one shock of demand during the initial phase of COVID. Many companies broke. We have a lot of many companies in the mainly medium companies, medium and small companies broken during this period. We have an increase in unemployment. With these two kind of shocks, we have to use new strategies to commercialize and to maintain sales. And this was one effort to mitigate the economic effects of COVID-19. So, comparing B2B and B2C, business to business, the relationship between two companies, more intense and duradoura relacionamento, a demanda gera os consumidores subsequentes, a relação de consumidor-vendedor é de grande predominância, e você tem consumidores mais especializados, no B2B. B2C, né? Os relacionamentos são mais curtos, menos intensos, a demanda é direcionada por escolhas, emoções e gostos, o relacionamento comprador-vendedor acontece com menos recorrência, você tem um consumidor menos especializado. So, this is a comparison between B2B and B2C. According to NIST, né, the Instituto Nacional de Tecnologia, né, de SaaS, this company use SaaS. What is SaaS? SaaS é um modelo, né, que possibilita conveniente acesso tempo real para compartilhar e customizar recursos computacionais, networks, redes, servidores, armazenagem, aplicações e serviços que podem ser rapidamente desenvolvidos com esforço de gestão e interação com o consumidor. Some forecasts related to the textile industry in Brazil. This graph is very interesting because we can see that in this period there was occurring an increase in salaries. In this graph, we can see too that the productivity don't have the same the same increase during this period. The materials and methods. This research was one actual research when the researcher participate and get involved with the investigation. So we will see all the phases of one actual research, action, act, control and description, investigate, evaluate, and plan the how to improve based in the paths. The company, I put the company ABC, but some people will see that the source of the data is Casablanca. That company was founded in 1999, and 2003 have the first line. In 2018, begins the online sales, only B2B. And with the COVID, begins the B2C direct sales using marketplace. The search was developed from March 2020 to April 2021. Sales process. The sales process, we can see here in this graph, in this figure, the two kind of sales that the company have. In the first, indirect sales, you will use retailers and sales representative. In the direct sales, you can sell the your product using your own site or using platforms like the marketplace. This is the product of the company. You can see the main product. And this table presenta os principais marketplace, né, que a empresa usa. The main marketplace are Magazine Luiza. And here we have the expenses with commission. Magazine Luiza earns 16%, Daft 17%, Olist 19%, B2W 16%, Madeira 20%, Site Proprio, owner all site of the company, 0%. And this is the main expenses that you have. Here, this graph shows the sales evolution during the period evaluated. It is interesting to notice it. Here, we have the first impact of COVID with a strong decrease in sales. There's more cooperation, but again, with problems of decrease in sales. But after some moment, when you begin to use the marketplaces, you will notice that you will see high increases in the sales during the period. Again, now, agora vendo a questão do volume de vendas, né? Unidades, a first moment with decrease, one period of stability, but with a very low number. And when you begin to go to marketplace, you have increase, some fluctuation showing that with your marketplace, you have more variations, strong variations, but strong increase. Share of each platform, the total revenue. Quanto cada plataforma participa da receita total? We see that your list is the biggest platform with the sales. Well, this is a very specific platform because sells in many different places. You contract a list and this platform made the announcements in very different kind of platforms. Then you have B2W and Magazine is another great retailer in Brazil, and Daft, very strong company in the style sector. Share in volume between the e-commerce, you will see again the role played by these three platforms. And the evolution of all website. The company during this period constructed their own website. And you see, compared with the marketplace, that the whole website begins to have results, mainly in this year. Gross margin valuation added for the main products of the company. Here we don't have data because it's very confidential information, but this information is very interesting. The gross margin of e-commerce, and it is very interesting. The gross margin added is in some kind of products of 40%, and in another very close to 40%. This in a very competitive sector like the textile sector is a very significant number. Besides this, the observation of the numbers was conducted two interviews, in deep interview, with the owners of the company, part number one and part number two. We see a convergence between the two directors that mixed sales provides greater security, maior segurança e previsibilidade de faturamento e greater predictability of billing. Não existem respostas, não existe uma grande, com relação ao posicionamento, uma grande disparidade. O parceiro 1 acredita que não vai ter problemas para continuar um bom relacionamento. O parceiro 2 acredita que o e-commerce vai gerar problemas para a empresa no futuro, porque vai ter choques, to emerge choques with traditional channels of sales. Os canais tradicionais de venda vai começar a ter cada vez mais conflitos. Os parceiros também veem que o impacto das vendas online de formas diferentes. Parceiro 1 enfatiza que existem problemas. O parceiro 2 afirma que o e-commerce vai competir com outros revendedores online. E isso aqui não vai ser positivo para a companhia, né? Na verdade, existe uma discordância aqui dos dois parceiros, né, da empresa, dos dois diretores, se a venda online vai ser boa ou não. There is a strong difference between the view of each director about the future of online sales. For the one, there is no problem. For the partner two, there will be higher problems in the future. Finally, I asked the intro to construct one SWOT matrix with the strengths. The main strengths was personality of the sales channels, good relationship with retailers, agility to adapt to these new challenges generated by pandemics. Weakness, the number of workers that deals with online sales is small. And even with the increase in the whole site, the sales was not so significant. Maybe if we compare with the sales generated by the marketplace. Opportunities. Expansion of clients. Now the company with online sells to all the Brazilian economy. Higher margins, sales margins, and the reduction of the intermediaries during the sales process. Teeth, clients, consumers, and resellers affirm that online sales have been causing prejudice to them, difficulties to compete in price with bigger companies in the online environment. The competition is much more intense. And there is some divergences, opinion divergences about the role that e-commerce will play in the future of the company. Financial aspects. Mesmo com essas mudanças, né, as vendas online cresceram muito, as margens tiveram uma melhora de 14% para 40%. Uma grande oportunidade, né, para aumentar a margem. Ganhou novos consumidores com as plataformas digitais. E as vendas online promoveram uma redução na necessidade da empresa para caixa, né? Por quê? as vendas online são mais curtas do que aquelas, o receivement period, the period that the company received, the sales are shorter than compared with the traditional retail. As pequenas e médias empresas, né, conseguiram, né, mais equidade, mais competitividade dos grandes players, com as grandes empresas. Relationship with clients, favorável, né? Aspectos favoráveis qualitativos e quantitativos. Expansão das vendas online, não afetaram o relacionamento com os varejistas. The first moment, there's no problem. O desenvolvimento da melhorias do processo de compra para ambos os clientes. Aspecto de cliente também que foi gerado, a mudança para online, the online change, the view of the company. And now, the company perceive a need to constant product development. And this, foi desconstruído alguns processos de criação. Os produtos do catálogo, né, também ajudaram a cada tipo de venda. Existe uma necessidade de investir em mais empregados, né, para dar suporte ao processo de pós-venda no e-commerce. Aspectos organizacionais. Avaliação positiva em relação aos proprietários, mas, né, ainda existe um impacto na identidade da companhia. A empresa está num momento de sucesso, mas ao mesmo tempo de crise de identidade. I have one company identity crisis because of the online generate questions to the company. What will be the future of the company? Vendas online aumentaram durante o período, né, e mudaram o processo de manufatura, né? Nesse sentido, a empresa interrompeu a questão de trabalho fornecido por outras empresas no setor têxtil e focou mais nos produtos marca própria. Adequação do número de empregados, né, de uma forma consistente, e uma desenvolvimento de estratégia através de planejamento de parcerias, de objetivos e de indicadores de performance que podem ser mensurados. So, this is the presentation. As I said the beginning, it's very interesting because in this case study during the pandemics, we have another situation, a situation that one company increased so much her sales during the pandemics, because the company goes to online, to e-commerce, to sell their products. So, this is the presentation. If someone has some doubts, I can try answer. There's no questions? No? Fine. So, if there's no questions, I will open to. Okay, okay. If there's no questions, I will hope that someone who wants to expose final comments, feel free to thank you to the others. And we are just close to our time to finish your presentation. So I will open to comments about our session that we have today. And that I plan continues in the next October 8th with some additional research conducted with the help of your researchers to investigate the impacts. We began with the impacts of COVID in the cultural life, and then with some additional comments to the business. Chris, I don't know if in Usher products we can see this. I became surprised. Eu fiquei surpreso com esse resultado. The company was not oriented for luxury products, was oriented for what in when we discuss the textile industry, we have three main segments. Price, we call another mold price, that is a mixture between price and mold. And mold. In mold, you have the role played by the brand. And the luxury price and luxury products probably will suffer, will feel more like we can see more in this category of luxury when brand is very important. But when I ask my student what is the segment that they offer their products, he talks to me that it was in price model. So the products can't be considered luxury. And for my surprise, when they go to the marketplace, they feel that they can now have sales to all the Brazilian economy with a strong appeal in price. It talks to me that the appeal of price is very important to survive in this field. But we don't have a very strong differentiation. It's not like the behavior of the luxury products. I don't know, this could be interesting to see the impact in luxury products during the pandemics. I don't know what happened with the luxury products, but it is very interesting to see if this is a very interesting question, because luxury products can be seen as products with some social distinction. And with social distancing, probably luxury products maybe could be more affected, but we don't know this information. But in the case Yes, it's a good team to investigate. I don't know what happened with the Russian products. Price wrote the intermediate products, as we can see, have a great increase during the pandemic, mainly because of the use of the marketplace. In this case, it is interesting because the company developed, a companhia desenvolveu um novo canal de vendas. A new sales channel was developed. Maybe this new channel was responsible for this high increase. It's an interesting question. Luxury products, maybe. Será que os produtos de luxo podem se adaptariam bem a um canal de vendas online? Essa é uma questão interessante. It's an interesting question. Matheus, quer fazer alguma pergunta?
No, I was going to say that maybe those esse aumento of the luxury products
increase
of the sale of those luxury products on the pandemics, it's some hedonic buying. I can't travel, I can't go to the mall, I can't go to a restaurant, I can't do anything, I'm going to buy some fancy things, some luxury things to make me more happy. Maybe something like this.
Maybe. I don't know. I have in the past students, I have one article in luxury products. And luxury products generally are oriented by a distinction. You buy something that have a distinctive effect. You have a very important brand, a very prestigious car. And I don't know, because we will need to investigate if the effect of prestigious, that is very social, was the predominant, or if for some hedonic pleasure, people increased the luxury consumption. I don't know. But it's another interesting question to investigate. During the pandemics, what happened? People have a great consumption of luxury products. Today we see that in healthy products, it works. And we see with our research that it's very interesting because the fear and the consumption have interaction, but was not so strong as we imagined in the beginning. So the presentations today show that we have a great avenue to investigate about the changes during the pandemic period.
Yes, I saw that the construction products have an increase of sales either. We stay at home, we redecorated the living room, the bathroom. So maybe it's an interesting field for study. Which product increases more the sales on the pandemics and why?
Yes, we can investigate. If this trend to stay more at home generate more changes, I have a cottage, and during this period I buy a third trees to put in my cottage, 30 new trees, and I was talking to the retailer, what is happening? And the retailer of trees, fruits mainly, said the trees, the sales of fruits and trees, trees that generate fruits, increases so much that never he sells so much trees like in this period. It's interesting because when you stay home, you discover new things to do. What people do during this period? Yesterday, I was, Tuesday, I was seeing the Champions League with my son, the football things. And during the interval, was a very interesting advertising of Heineken. Heineken is the great sailor that made announcements during the intervals. And they used the social distancing appeal.
Yeah.
Oh, even when you stay in your home, you are not alone. And the man opened one Heineken during a goal. And when occurs a goal, a lot of apartment lights turn on and people say, go. I was talking this to my students. The appeal of social distancing is very strong for this reason that probably Heineken was using social distancing appeal to people to feel connected. This, the social distancing effect, may be an interesting survey that we can conduct. Today, I was talking with my students about social distancing, and many of them talked to me that they feel a lot of effect of social distancing. For us, we are professors. I was talking to them that as professor works a lot of the time alone, talks to the students, teach classes, but basically live alone. So we can suffer so strong influence in the social distancing effect. But for my students, I was talking to the students about this, they feel a very strong effect of social distancing. So social distancing in these last minutes, it's a theme that we can investigate with a survey that it will be very interesting, the social distancing, the academic life, because as I noticed today, students feel a lot of effects of social distancing. And probably the society, the Heineken advertising was directed to the younger public, all the people that are commemorating the goal, celebrating the goal, as younger people that are not together. And even Heineken adopted one specific strategy for social distancing to deal with social distancing. So it's one idea that you can investigate in a further research, social distancing effects on home operations, home consumptions, and even for in academic life. I won't expect a so strong effect of social distancing for my students. It's very interesting. The pandemics have better results today. The numbers in Brazil are not so high like in the past, but the social distancing effect was occurring because we will have distance classes and our life in home until this end of this year. But it's very interesting, the questions that was presented, Lucio in the effects of this period of changes in life, in general, life and us, considering us as people that are living with social distancing, much more intense than the past.
Everybody had to change something to survive the pandemic. Everybody changed a habit, consumption habit, or living habit. Everybody did something. You said you talk about trees, and there is a lot of urban farms. Myself, I began to plant vegetables on the backyard to do something at home. Everybody did something.
Yes. The effects of the social distancing.
Yeah.
Very interesting. I propose that we discuss the next survey that we can. I will try to find some papers about social distancing and consumption, because probably the effect of social distancing is higher than the effects of fear. I was just thinking about this today.
Probably.
More questions, more comments? So we will finish our presentation. I will thanks Roman, Matheus, and all the people that participate in this meeting. E a todos os estudantes que viram e que acompanharam a discussão pelo YouTube. Obrigado a todos. Thank you for all. And see you on October 8th. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. And
see you soon.
Bye, and see you soon.
Bye.